You and Your Health is brought to you by Doctors Save a Life Foundation. You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Hello. What a pleasure meeting you once again in this special edition of You and Your Health. Remember that You and Your Health is a program sponsored by Doctors Save a Life Foundation, a non-governmental organization with a clear vision of giving total health to the people of Africa through the power of knowledge. Today we are going to talk about the secret things. Because, you know, when it has to do with the sexual life of an individual, that is where we place the word private. You get that? They call it private organs when it has to do with their sexual health and all that. But today we are going to talk something that has to do with the sexual problems of men and also the sexual problems of women. Hear me, it will be a very explosive one, because you have to learn a lot of things here today, and by so doing you'll be in position to empower yourself to know what to do before the evil days will come. And before I go into that, I want you to pick up your phone right now, call your friends, call your well-wishers, tell them to tune in right now. It's going to happen again. And this time around, it's going to be something fantastic. So many people have been complaining to you on what we're going to talk today. And by the grace of God, they will see a way of escape by reason of you contacting them. And do that quickly. I'll be right back.
You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
I do hope this program has been a blessing to you. And if you have been a fan of this particular unique program or a partner to Dr. Save a Life Foundation, you will understand our driving passion toward this particular goal. And that particular goal is Operation Total Health to the people of Africa through the power of knowledge. You know what? Many people have been asking, what actually motivated you? What has given you this very drive to go all this out with the whole of your heart, energy, and everything? I will tell you, in 2003, there was a horrifying statistic that came on board, and that has to do with the issue of HIV/AIDS. Then the death was horrible. And the statistic came on board that 72% of the global death following HIV/AIDS occurred in Africa. And that got so many people talking. A lot of analysts from across the globe emphasizing that because of the socio-economic status of African nations, particularly Sub-Saharan Africa, stating that it's because of poverty and all that and all that. But one of the days, on the course of my meditation over this situation, God gave me a clearer information about the challenge. And that is what he put it and said, the problem of the health of the people of Africa is not poverty, because poverty is a global phenomenon. Get to United States, get to UK, you will see poverty. See seated, a lot of people will see beggars. You get that? But he put something very unique. He said that the problem of the health of people of Africa is centered on the lack of information on health knowledge. He said, through knowledge shall the just one be delivered. Therefore now, decode this medical information in a common man's language. By so doing, millions of lives can be saved through the power of knowledge. And you know what? That also confirm God's word that said, my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. Not because of witches, not because of poverty, not because of this, but because knowledge is not available in that particular peculiar area of your life. Whatever you suffer, knowledge problem. And he said that through knowledge shall the just one be delivered. Now, I want us to also, in addition to what is happening, do you know that as it stands today, the life expectancy of an average Nigerian is dropping on the daily note? Look at the rate of death. Look at how people are just dying suddenly there, so many things, all manner of sickness. But you know what? Despite the fact that those sicknesses are there, as it could also be found abroad, I recently was with a man in the United States that came back from coma after 14 days. He had cardiac arrest. He had aneurysm. Things that if it happened here, the person is already in the grave. But over there, this man is still alive, taking care of his family and also adding to the society. Now, what is the problem of our people dying in this very horrifying sense that in most cases is either one devil or one problem or is spiritual and all that? Now, let me tell you why people die here. I will tell you now, even if you are dying, may this word bring resurrection back to your health. And the one thing is, Satan has capitalized on the ignorance of our people and keep killing so many people in silence. May I ask you, who told you that that problem you are suffering is spiritual? Who has convinced you on those things you are drinking without going to hospital? Without doing anything, he said, no, I don't believe in going to hospital. That particular concussion, that thing you are drinking, you don't know anything about it, but that is what you feel, that is your own health. Who told you that what you are suffering is the poison you mashed? Some people will say, no, I have done everything and the problem is not going. What have you done? Can you bring that very thing you say, I have done this one, I have done this one. A man came and asked, what can I do to enter the kingdom? He said that this, Jesus told him. He said, no, all this have I done. But Jesus said, you lack one thing. I tell you, that thing you are passing through, you feel that, no, there is this problem, it is a spiritual problem. There is something that you ought to do you have not done. If you doubt me, bring the things you claim that you have done, and I will show you that that devil is only deceiving you, waiting the time you will be close to the grave, then they will not rush you to the hospital. At that point they are rushing you to the hospital, the worst had already happened. Then doctors will not do any magic, because early diagnosis of any problem, including cancer, is as good as prevention. Now, I want us to look at this. I do hope you will feel my passion. Now hear this. There is something that devil has succeeded in stealing from us, but he didn't leave us empty. He replaced us with something that is not real, very, very fake. And what is it? That people have placed priority into the things they will acquire more than their health. A man can do anything in order to get money, buy a car, buy land, buy furnitures, buy things, buy clothes, buy this. Sometimes people can owe, even to get them. But once it comes to their health, it becomes very painful to be attended to. Satan in operation, I will tell you. When it comes to your own health, it becomes painful for you to give the best to your health. And you know what Jesus said in the book of Luke 12 verse 15? He said, beware of covetousness. Beware of acquisition of this. He said, a man's health cannot be compared to the abundance of things he possesses. Hey! Watch our politicians in the recent time, who you have seen commanded all manner of things. See them in their health today. You will know your health is more important than that car and all the things you are thinking about. Your health is your prosperity. Your health is your life. Permit me to tell you, you know, devil is so wicked. And you know what? The Bible says he comes to steal. If he doesn't kill you, he will steal the opportunities you have. Now listen, do you know, as you are today, you have nothing. Oh, Satan is a deceiver. You have nothing. Somebody will say, this is my land. My friend, you have no land. This is my house. It is not yours. You who eat not. This my this. This my this. This my this. You have nothing here. The Bible declares the earth is of the Lord. The fullness thereof, all that dwell in it. Now hear me. The only possession or asset you have is your health. You know what? The day you die, the land will go back to the owner, which is God. He may tomorrow give it to somebody that is not linked to you at all. The house you think is your own. No, it's not yours. They will only keep your corpse momentarily there and take it out of that very place and be buried somewhere. What happened to the so-called house you are beating your chest for? You don't have any knowledge about it. You are growing older and older. Nothing tells you that why your skin changes is because you are going closer to the grave. You can't deny it, for it is appointed unto man one day to die. It is a thing that is there. But to get to longevity, this your health needs to be serviced. That is the essence of you having an attention on this your health. Your health supposed to receive the best. You know why I say so? If you break down, number one is that your family will suffer. Two, you will eat the money that you think you already have. I've seen people who have come to a crossroad in the journey of their health. Money can help them out. They will sell properties, but not the solution. The money you have, you will spend it. You also be in position whereby not being able to get another. You will be under stress, your family will be under stress, and so many things. Because your health is the principal thing. That's why you don't need things to enjoy life. You need life first in order to enjoy things. But devil put it the opposite. You need things to enjoy life. No, you can have things. When life is not there, it's not enjoyable. When your health is not there, it's not enjoyable. I will encourage you from today. Attention to this, your health is very, very paramount. If you lose your health, you lose everything. About 2011, I happened to have a man. This man got kidney failure. You know what's called kidney failure? The kidney failed. And he was to do kidney transplant. I had the opportunity then to fly him outside the country to do kidney transplant as of then, $16,000, which came out to about $2 million something as of that time. But you know what? This man resorted to the issue of prayers. I'm not saying that prayer is not good, but I'll tell you something that I want to be very, very emphatic about. So many prayer warriors were just praying, prophecies were coming on him. And the man continued as they were praying. Unfortunately, God didn't come on time. The man died. Do you know what happened? When he died, it was discovered that this man had 20 million naira in a fixed deposit, waiting to use it to complete his estate. And when he died, they buried him. Some months later, I saw one of the sons. And I met him and said, "Hi, my friend. How was it? Have you people done the burial? I hope it went well." He said, "Wow, it was wonderful. We gave him a befitting burial." Befitting burial. That's one of the things that so many of us are celebrating. One man said, "Instead of me spending this money, I better keep it, make the use and bury me." You never hear that kind of a thing before. Instead of a man said, he's already buried. I don't know whether they use the money for him. He doesn't even know. He had a prostate cancer and he was told, "Attend to it this way." He said, "No, instead of me spending this money, let me take that money and bury him." so that they will celebrate my burial. They will give me defeat. You don't hear that type also. Royal burial. Royal burial. Befitting burial. Ignorance is the mother of personal destruction, involuntary misfortune. And it is worse when you are ignorant of your ignorance. And I asked the young man, my friend, it was quite befitting. But how much did you people spend? He said, wow, we spent 5.4 million. They spent 5.4 million naira to bury him. If I say that foolish man, it may become an insult to the family. I will hold that very word. I didn't say so. But I know that heaven will judge him as a man who committed suicide. No, nothing. Careful with in his judgment, even if he's a righteous man, he's wicked to himself. We may say, straight into hell. Or if he has small opportunity, stay for purgatory for some time. Very painful. You know, I asked myself this question. Why has devil so clothed us with the ceremony of celebrating death? Do you know the implications of that man's death? You know, if you are not intelligent, you only think only one way. Do you know that that man that died, who had 20 million as fees deposit in the bank, must have a super brain to be able to create wealth? Which implies, if he had been able to do the kidney transplant and remain alive, his brain is alive, he can get more money. He could be in position to secure the status of the family. He will be in position to see the children through, because what he has in the brain buried cannot be transferred to anybody. And that man decided, okay, instead of me spending this money, I better go. The children will suffer it. He won't get another. He's already in the grave. And I tell you, the presence of a man in the family is a moral booster to the children. Eh? With or without money, my father is there. Those ones you leave for the woman to manage, to struggle, emotional tears and emotional attachment may not allow her to see those children well, if not by God's grace. Go and take history of those their father died. You discover that few that survive is just the hand of God that pushed them out of disaster. So, it becomes imperative, even you as a mother, listen to me, if you die untimely by all those nonsense things you say, attack this one, I won't go to hospital. If you die, I tell you, you may end up leaving your children as slaves. They may be slaves in their own father's house. Your presence is a defense to their tomorrow and the peace of their life. Give it to them by attending to your health. Give it to them by attending to your health. You may not find it elsewhere. Spend money. Get your health. You will get money back. Imagine the hard devil has succeeded. A heart wrecks. When I remember the state, the devil has not only put up the people, but more on God's children. Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. But in church today, we celebrate burial more than we celebrate the recovery, the health of our people. A sister in the church, we have a problem, and everyone will be praying for her. She may have a problem, 100,000 may be in position to take care. Everybody will know, everybody will become poor. Maybe on a church, The pastor will bring out basin or something as for offering and say, let us contribute as an offering to this our sister who is not well. That very day, everyone in the church will become poor. People will be bringing 100 naira, 50 naira, 20 naira. Maybe the whole church may contribute 8,050 naira. The whole church. But as soon as this sister will now struggle with death, battle with death, and the pains of death and die, and the pastor will come, or the reverend will come, or the bishop will come to the altar and say that, beloved, our sister has gone to be with the Lord. Be with who? Who sent her to be with the Lord? That is not God's agenda. He don't go. Now we send them. He said he has gone to be with the Lord. Why God expected her to be here and contribute to the kingdom's growth? And we say she has gone to be with the Lord. And do you know the painful aspect of it? It becomes so painful that now the church will say, let us prepare for the burial. You know that in here church will be saying, you know that this is our burial, our own burial. It's our own burial. Nobody goes struggle with us, our own burial. Hey, say to fear. It is evil in the land. Church will say, our burial. And somebody will say, okay, let us do contribute for it. Somebody will raise hand and say, Nami go buy coffee. 25,000 or 30,000. Nami go buy the coffee. Church will begin to clap. Hey! Rikamasatalaba. May God deliver us from death. You now begin to clap. Somebody will say, yeah, I will provide. The same church that were putting 100 naira, 50 naira, will now come up with a chobi, a choke, both a chi of every kind, and we eat. And say that today in our burial, may God not curse the church. Why is the poverty? Why is the poverty there? The poverty is because we are sowing in the land of the dead and not in the land of the living. We are sowing in the land of the dead. A person will be in church, will suffer and suffer, will only be waiting for the person to die. And everybody will be contributing money. Contributing money. Then he's saying that we are giving. The burial is our burial. Our sister will not see shame. That is the word. Our own sister who is dead will not see shame. Where will he be to see shame? I will say, no, that our sister will not see shame. You are the one seeing shame, not her. Not the person in the grave. My friend, I just want us to come up as a unit, as a family, as a society, and say enough is enough for satanic deceit. My problem, yes, he say they tell you it is spiritual. And you are relaxing and dying? No, they say if you go to hospital, you will die. And you are dying and you are relaxing? Come and see the way churches are burying people. And they are burying people and calling upon devil Jesus have put under our feet. Calling upon people that belong to one court or the other court. And you see the church panicking in their presence. Whereas, you see, all power in heaven on earth has been given unto me. Who is deceiving us here? Hour has come for us possibly rebel against ignorance and wickedness of men, taking advantage of people. We'll give you one prophecy to be afraid of by reason of being afraid. Somebody once said that, do you know that man that is behaving like that? I know the type of prophecy I will give him now, he will come back. Hey! Evil. Wisdom is profitable to give direction. I'm not saying there is no satanic manipulation, but I'm here to say glory be to God, who has delivered us from the powers of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of His Son, caused us to be seated with Christ in heavenly places far above all the enchantments of hell. That is what I believe. That is what I stand. Anyone telling you less is deceiving you, is putting you under. You're supposed not to be under the fear of any gods. Never. It's not written in God's words. Anything contrary is Satan. My heart bleeds because recently somebody that is close, unfortunately, they tell him all manner of things. They continue carrying him up and down, carrying him up and down. Today is late. The children are there. The children have become fatherless on things that are preventable and treatable, as it were. I wish you will understand me. I'm sorry if I've actually shouted at my heart over this. But I wish we could go out there and stop that satanic language going around. Evil. It is evil. Don't take this, drink that. Go to hospital. As God has made technology to advance, so He has done so much in medical environment. So much has been done currently. So much. There are a lot of things that God has improved to make sure we see what we don't used to see before. May God help us. I pray you join me in this effort. God bless you for being a party to it. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this program. For sponsorship and support, call 0810-000-0851 or 0810-000-0651. WhatsApp on 0803-710-8150 or visit our website at www.saveralifemissions.com. You can also stay connected with us through any of these our social media accounts. Join Save a Life Partners to build a healthy family and a healthy society.